Hey, it's me.
Let's see. Hold on. Here we go. I got it right now.
T from the Pattersons taking a train to Tibet. I'm talking to you. Just a second. Get my stuff together because you know it's early morning. From an undisclosed location. But look, I'm being mercifully short because I woke up a while ago. Actually, I was lucky because last night I listened to Yvette and stuff like that. But then I went and I was in a bathtub and I took a bath. I have this big bath up here. And you know, you take a hot bath. Boy, when you go to sleep then, you sleep. I was dead, you know. And my sister happened to call, woke me up and said, oh. Whatever time she called, I usually wake up at like 5 or something like that. Anyway, the point really is that, you know, let me just say, in fact, when I woke up, I went and did I do some my prayer and meditation prayer, take my pills, prayer and exercise. And, you know, so I do this routine all the time, but, you know, every once in a while, you know, I get bored. Just my nature, or I'm a playwright. I'm always adjusting and stuff like that. So what happens? I started to incorporate my prayer in, you know, into my exercise. Quite good. I think I'll keep on in that. Adjust, which is what I'm talking about real quick. We need to adjust. Oh, I'm eating my goat's milk yogurt, and I cut up an apple, put some cinnamon and some turmeric in there, and. I can't talk to my mouth full. This little tiny breakfast is get my system started. But I'm going to Trader Joe's in a little while. I got to meet my fraternity brother. You know, Trader Joe's, he got a car. So stock up for the last time. But hey, they're supposed to hit a peak or something like that. So I'm probably going to sequester myself for a bit. But that's not why I'm calling you. That's why I'm talking to you real quick. So what happens, like I'm trying to tell you, make sure you keep on grooming yourself, you know, make yourself good, get your vitamin D, sun's going to be out this morning, you know, I'm going to walk down to Trader Joe's, meet him down there, and you know, get your vitamin D and all that stuff, but, you know, as usual, I check in with the internet, you know, in the morning, stuff like that, I don't deal with TV, you know, secular talk, Kyle Kalinske, and he was reporting that, I'm sorry. Things are so absurd to me. If you see like a laugh or a giggle at something, it's only because it's absurd. I'm not laughing at it. I'm saying it's an absurd situation. And it just triggers some sort of reflex in me, you know? At any rate, so there's reporting that there's like, I forgot. I'm just saying, I think it's 250 million masks that the people had, you know, but the government wouldn't buy it right away because too many middlemen are trying to get through it. I don't know whatever the story is. The point is, there was a lot of masks. He's also saying, like, one of the things that the Chinese did, because they can do it, you know, their frontline people are working in hazmat suits. Boy. Now, who's a dunghole country? Come on now. Anyway, the point is, so that's one thing. And then when I was listening to Yvette last night, you know, the part I like the most is that when the callers, you get a lot of information from callers, people on the ground and stuff like that. So his brother was saying that there was a report coming out because they don't have the racial breakdown for the deaths yet. But they say but by zip codes, it seems like Brooklyn, Queens, and Bronx, my beloved Bronx, have the highest cases. And of course, they're in the poorest area because you can go by zip code because of red lines, stuff like that, you know, how people live. And it's interesting because, and this is, nobody's reported that yet, but the brother, you know, called in Yvette's show. So I'm going like, huh. See, immediately I knew that, you know, this delay that Trump was doing because the delay that Trump was doing was so that whatever his people can get in place so they can, you know, then charge the government and do whatever they do. But here's the thing. I don't understand why people don't understand. Everybody said Trump this and Trump that. What is the matter with you? Let's start thinking. Come on now. Let's go back to Obama. I'm not going to go back further to Obama. Obama got elected by you know, the people, right? And what did he do? Immediately, Citibank hiding about, maybe they before, you know, put things in place. So basically he did a bidding. His people, he left them alone, and his people then became Citibank because he wants to ascend to that. I don't know. He wants to, I don't know. He's tapping into, I don't know what he was doing. So that was clear. It was clear. If it wasn't clear, if it's not clear to you, here's what you do, because this is what I did. Get his book, right? That Audacity of Hope, the political one, not the daddy one, right? And read it now. Just start reading it. Just don't even read the whole. Just start reading it now. You know, skip past a few pages. Start reading it now. And if you really late, then go. I guess it's an audio book too. You start listening to it now. I defy you to try to get through that whole book. You can't do it, because when you realize how the betrayal that he did to the peoples is amazing. It's simply amazing. And I don't get into Obama right now. But when Trump came in, I'm going like, everything he's doing for his people. He said, who is his people? His people, real estate people. That's who he comes from. I'm going to leave the mob alone. The real estate people, you know, he grew up rich, whatever, you know, and a certain, I'm trying to tell you, Trump is not as stupid as you think. Even the stimulus thing, somebody was bringing out the fact that, remember, a lot of Republican governors from these states, right, that they didn't accept the Obamacare, whatever have you, so they didn't have no insurance. But the stimulus, it helps them out. So he's even as he's doing this stuff, he's doing his political stuff. I don't understand why people can't see this. It's unbelievable. So and so in other words, those states that didn't sign up for Obamacare, they wasn't getting anything. This stimulus thing, this will help them out. So when it's election time coming, he's got his whole, everything is wrapped up in those states already. This is exhausting. What I'm trying to say, as you get this information, what are we doing with this information? If they're doing stuff, we're just getting information, but we're not doing anything. That's my problem. We're not doing a darn thing. It's a huge problem. It's so frustrating. At least if we're all home, I got to do this myself, you're right. You need to write your representative, or when I suggest you, everybody in the chain, or we used to do this. I guess you do it here too. You know, you write your representative in longhand, right? Or you can write the email, but then you actually go and write another. You write in longhand, you know, or even type, right? And so what you do is you send the email out, but then you take that letter and you mail that letter to whoever you're supposed to mail it to. You see? And you certain fact, just like I was just doing certain, you just do a couple of facts. You know what I mean? Don't do a whole bunch of this, and have a list of 25. Just, you know, maybe two things, you know. It seems I found out that, you know, did so many masks with it in. Well, how come you're not dealing with this right now? Or, you know, it seems like, you know, my zip code has more things than these other zip codes. Whatever your 2 points are, you put that in a letter and send it off. I got to do this so you'll understand what I'm saying. Anyway, so my point really is, and I'll end it here because we got to go. I just want to post this up real quick. But my point is, we have this time. Do something. After you groom yourself, you wake up and you get your good night's sleep, get your bath, get your good night's sleep, drink your hot water and lemon in the morning, and at night before you go to sleep, drink your hot chamomile tea, whatever have you. You get it. And sometimes, like right now, it's like I'll walk down to Trader Joe's, so I'll get a little bit of sun. I'll avoid people, whatever have you. But I'll get sun. I'll get sun, you know what I mean? My vitamin D, you know. So things you need to start really, we need to start, you know, adjusting, like I said, adjusting everything. So just stop. First of all, stop listening to TV. Stop listening to these pundits. We've scratched them off. Do your own research, please. Oh, I'm getting like Jimmy Dore now, just going crazy. So look, that's it. You understand what I'm saying. So I'll check y'all later, right? See you.